sports that's keeping on top of your teams and news, stats, and wins. This is SIBN Sports.
What's up, y'all? We are back at the sports desk. This is your girl, Clara Select, and I am here with none other than the man himself,
Matthew Hugs.
That's his name. Y'all know him very well. Now, listen, y'all.
I hope so.
I know you hear some noise in the background. We got a little issue going on today. We got some construction in the studio. We're trying to work on some things. So if you hear a little buzzing in the background, it's no big deal. You know, just have to upgrade some things here. Now, I have a big, big surprise for y'all today. We just going in. We going to have some fun. We have a lot to talk about, don't we?
Always. We always do.
OMG. Last week was ridiculous. Can you say ridiculous?
Ridiculous.
Yes, it was. Y'all listen, in the studio with us today, we have a very special guest, fan and friend of the SIBN Sports Show. And we have asked him to come in and sit with us today because we wanted him to join in on the discussion, especially that of the Atlanta Falcons when we get to that one. But I want him to introduce himself to y'all. Here he is, none other than Big Country. What's up, Big Country?
Good evening. How you doing?
We are doing just great. So glad to have you on the show today. How does it feel to be here with SIBN today?
I just love you guys. I enjoy the show a whole lot.
Okay. Wonderful. Matthew, now listen, you're going to have to hold it together. I know you're not used to having someone in the studio with us, but you're going to be okay, all right? We can make it through this. Now, listen, we're going to start off with this. This is the big story right now. It is a huge story. I want to get it out there and be over with it because I think we're giving it way too much attention, to be honest with you. But the story about Armstrong. Now, we know that Lance is going to be on the Oprah Winfrey Network tonight. Network. And Lance is going to say, I'm guilty. Okay.
Right.
He's going to say, I did it. Okay.
I did it.
Big Country, what do you think about this whole situation with Lance Armstrong?
Well, like we used to say back in the days, you know, you just can't be a superhero without a little kryptonite being put into your system.
Mm-hmm.
And if we'd have gave that to the chickens out on the farm, we'd have had some big eggs like that. You know what I'm talking
yes,
about?
Maybe we should have gave them some. Well, it definitely helped him win 7-2 at the Francis now that we know that he definitely used performance-enhancing drugs so that he could win. It wasn't like he just used them. You know how some people, when they come out, they'll say, I used them and I'm admitting to using them, but some of it was I didn't really know what was being put into mm-hmm. me and things like that. You know what I'm saying?
Well,
we've heard all
types
of stories.
And there are people.
But with him, he hasn't said that. He said, I used it to win.
Well, at the time, and here's the thing now, is that like you said, he didn't admit to it back then, and that's what he should have. But he said, well, that was my purpose. But now he's probably looking into it to try to find an excuse to saying like, well, I didn't know because there are athletes out there that do get doctors that, you know, they overprescribe them because they're paying them a lot of money. And then guess what? Everybody's a guilty party. So,
right.
One of
the things that I found out this morning was that he can't be prosecuted right now because he's past
statute of limitation.
Yes. So he's past the statute of limitations. So that means that they can't go after him for perjury at this point. Big Country, what do you think about that?
Well, that's what they do out there on that. Once you take things illegal, they wait until the statute of limitation run out so they can go ahead and talk about it.
Yeah, yeah. So he's being slick, huh?
He's being slick. See, yeah. If you want to win at any by any means necessary,
mm-hmm.
but you know, some of the things that we need to look out in these athletes is winning seem to be the only thing that we want to do to win, not to have fun. I thought the whole catching the game is to have fun, but it's not.
Right. So Lance Armstrong has proven to everybody. And, you know, and along with this story, I'm also going to talk about Scott. And the reason I'm bringing up Stuart Scott of ESPN, the announcer for ESPN, his cancer has returned. And so he's doing chemo every Monday for his cancer that has returned. He has two daughters, one 17 and one 13. And he says that the first thing that came to his mind was his daughter. But guess what? He came in defense of Armstrong because he said, even though Armstrong is coming out to admit that he doped, he said, we cannot take away from him all that he has done for cancer research and cancer survivors. What do you think about that, Matthew?
Well, he kind of dug himself out with that one, and it's good that there's a witness out there that can definitely stand by him and say that, like, hey, this guy's done a lot of great work. Mm-hmm. Can that be taken away in the end? No. You just can't do it. Yeah. And, you know, Scott, you know, having cancer return, that's like he's, like I said, he's been there to be a witness. He's seen what this guy's done. He knows what he's done for kids, and that's the most important thing, especially in today's generation.
But do you think that's going to be a determining factor in his comeback, though, that people are going to get over this so quickly? Because you know how we are. You know, people do something wrong. Look at Barry Bonds. You know, prime example. You know, people have gotten over it. They thought he should have been elected into the Baseball Hall of Fame, and he wasn't. So people were upset about it. They said he should have been in there. Right? And people forget so quickly about those things that caused them to win. I don't know if we can say that about Barry Bonds, if, you know, he was a strong man. So I don't think that he doped to the point where it was the only reason he was hitting the home runs that he was hitting. Mm-hmm. But to me, Lance Armstrong is coming out and saying, I did this to win. I did this to win. I doped so that I could win because I wanted to be number one at the expense of everybody around him. And I think at the end of the day, that's the part I don't like, is that you tried to take other people down with you by threatening them, you know, and coming against them and all that, you know, to prevent them from being able to say what was going on. Mm-hmm. Right? Yeah. So they didn't want to come against him. Some out of fear and some, you know, out of concern for whatever reasons, you know. But, you know, for you to come out and use that and hold that over other people's head so that you could win, I just don't know how the other people benefit from that. It's kind of crazy, right?
Well, life is crazy. Yeah. And what we're dealing with right now is a crazy situation. It's just...
Yeah. Boy, I tell you one thing, it's hot in this studio today. Phones ringing, construction going down.
Rain coming at you.
Shoot.
What's next, guys?
What's next, right? So I wanted to get that story out the way, but I will say that he will be on the OWN network tonight. So if you want to watch him, my cable channel OWN is 170. I don't know what yours is, but I'm definitely going to be watching because I want to know what he has to say. I really do. I want to hear the story from his mouth. So, and not only that, I want to support my girl Oprah Winfrey Network. Hey, Oprah. She's a billion-dollar woman. I don't care what nobody say. She's still the woman when it comes to interviews. And that's why everybody still want to sit on the couch with Oprah. Do your thing, Oprah. So I will be watching because I want to support Oprah as well. But, you know, I just want to hear what he has to say. I really want the story to go away, to be honest with you, just for the simple fact I think we're giving him too much time. You know, you can give somebody too much time on the stage. You just keep on letting it keep going. And that's feeding what he is expecting. That's feeding what he's wanting, is to keep pushing his name out there to make him look like he's greater than he is. What you think?
Hey.
You don't have a lot to say about this, Matthew.
Time heals all wounds. I just don't know about this one.
This is true. You're not sure that it would work on this one. Big Country, what do you think? Do you think time will heal all wounds when it comes to Lance Armstrong?
Well, I think Chris Rock, the comedian, that's who I like.
Yeah.
He kind of sounded and rounded out all in one way. He said that sometimes if it's all white,
it's all right.
Oh.
Okay. And this is what we're going through right now with Lance Armstrong. Mm-hmm. Okay. He can't do no wrong.
Oh.
Even though he had support cancer. But supporting things under a lie, it's not right.
Yeah.
It's just not right. Yeah. And I don't know. It's just bringing me tears in my eyes.
Oh, no. Big Country, don't cry.
Right.
It's just hard to fathom that somebody would just be so cruel, huh?
It ain't going to go away, Claire.
You don't think it ain't going away? Well, y'all, you heard it here first on SIBN Sports. Big Country said it's not going to go away. This is going to be something that's going to be around for a long time. Even Matthew thinks that this is not one of those stories where it's just going to go away. Even though we say that time heals all wounds, will it really in this situation? Because I think the depth of it is the biggest thing we have to look at. It is so deep. What he has done. I mean, the cover-up alone, to me, is the part that I'm very upset about. I don't like the cover-up and how so many people that were around him had to suffer because of what he did and the decisions that he made. He made people's lives a living hell, and nobody deserves that. That's not a friend at all. I'm sorry, did I go off? I just went off.
I wouldn't say off. That'd be a little bit.
Listen, very exciting news. Y'all know I love golf, right? Tiger Woods and McElroy are good friends now. Oh, they're hanging out together, right? The number one seed, McElroy, he's only 23 years old. He's already won several titles. This kid is really on the move. So guess what? Guess who's picking him up?
Ooh.
The same people that picked up Tiger Woods when he was getting started. Nike! Nike ain't playing around, boy. They say we getting in on this golf thing. We're going to make it happen. So they are signing back.
Yeah, hopefully he doesn't do the exact same thing.
He has a great mentor in Tiger Woods. No matter what you say about him, like time heals all wounds. They've healed the wounds for me. Love me some Tiger Woods. Let's get it done. Let's get it cracking. Oh, and before we go to break, Tiger Woods has won 9 PA... the most PGA Tour money titles. Tiger Woods has won 9, Jack Nicklaus has won 8, Ben Hogan 5, and Tom Watson has won 5. Go Tiger, let's keep it going. He ain't done yet, y'all. Thank you so much for joining us here on SIBN Sports Desk. We're going to take a quick break. We're coming back at you with some more good news, sports talk. Let's do it. See you in a minute.
Hey.
It's always been a part of me to fight for those who couldn't fight for themselves. Whether on my block or around the world, my name is First Lieutenant King, and I move toward the sounds of those who are in need of help.
The few, the proud, the Marines.
Entry invalid.
Mode.
Mode.
5 seconds.
The Windows Phone 8X by HTC on Verizon. It features easy-to-navigate live tiles that are simple to customize. Just pin what matters most right to your home screen. Exclusively with DataSense, a feature that makes the most of your plan. Only on Verizon.
Hey, Mike. Where do you have to?
Just diagramming this accident with my State Farm Pocket Agent app. You can also get a quote and pay your premium with this thing.
I thought State Farm didn't have all those apps.
Where'd you hear that?
The internet.
And you believed it?
Yeah. They can't put anything on the internet that isn't true.
Where'd you hear that?
The internet. Oh, look. Here comes my date. I met him on the internet. He's a French model.
Bonjour.
State Farm. More mobile than ever. Get to a better state.
Aaron, I was able to save you hundreds.
Yeah, discount, double check, I know. I'm kind of over that move.
So are we.
What?
It's a little, soft.
No, it isn't.
It is.
They wanted something with a little,
Like what?
Do it with me. Ready? Discount, double check.
I like it.
Mm-hmm.
It's terrifying.
Right?
Matthews.
What's up, dude?
He plays football. Professionally.
Hey, Rogers! Move! Matthews!
You can save big with a discount double check. Only from State Farm.
You're listening to SIBN Radio on the Select USA TV iBroadcasting Network. You're listening to SIBN Radio.
Y'all, again, we're back.
We're running around in
the studio like crazy people, y'all, trying to make this thing happen for you because we appreciate all of your support. And we're just having a great time in the studio today, man. We're just going in real strong. We finished the story on Armstrong. Moving on. I want to talk about a great story, y'all. I really like this young lady, Hannah Storm, who works for the Sports Center. And I don't know if guys, everybody knows about what happened with her, but she was injured in an accident where she was burned severely. And you know what caused the accident? You know what caused it? She was just igniting her grill.
Ouch.
I know. And it set her on fire, and her daughters were the ones that were there to save her. And she has been out for a while, but she has returned to work. She said it has not been easy for her. But I just want to send a shout out to Hannah Storm. Congratulations on being back at work. She's having to spend a lot of time putting on makeup and things like that to cover up some of the burns that she sustained in that accident. So welcome back to ESPN, Miss Hannah Storm. Good luck to you, lady, and you're getting back to your regular schedule and doing what you do best. She's a great reporter for sports. And so, you know, I love seeing ladies doing sports. What do y'all think?
Well,
you do it, girl. Do
see.
You, girl. Oh, stop it. Yeah, right. Okay, check this out. Now, y'all know I love me some Serena Williams. So we're going to talk a little bit about tennis. Sharapova and Venus both have made the first round winners in the first round of the Australian Open. Serena is right now ranked number 3, and she is expected to win her 6th Australian Open title. So they're already calling her the winner of this thing, and it's just beginning. So that tells you a lot about the confidence that people have in Serena's play right now. That girl at 31 years old is doing the doggone thing.
Well, remember last week we talked about motivation and determination.
We talked about that, didn't we?
You have it set in the mind that you can beat anyone and everybody. You will beat anyone and everybody, and that's just the end of it. There's nothing you can do about it.
That is so true. And so, congratulations, big ups to Serena. Do your thing, girl, and make it happen. Holla! Okay, listen. Now, I've been waiting for this moment because I know Matthew got a lot to say. Wait a minute, Matthew, you had a story.
Well,
what was it called?
Well, here's the thing, guys.
Out the trash or something like that?
I didn't say it was out the trash. I said I found it in the trash.
Oh, I'm sorry. I misunderstood.
So I don't know who out there.
You said you found it in the trash. You
know, I don't know who actually out there could have read this, but, you know, I was passing by taking out my trash the other day, and the words on this newspaper says, NBA great, West reveals lifelong depression. Mm-hmm. Of course, not all that at one time, but as I saw it, I picked it up and I said, wow, I wonder how old this article is. This is an article, for those of you who don't know, the logo, the NBA logo, his name is Jerry West. And for those of you that don't know, he wore my favorite number, 44, played for the Lakers.
Okay.
Of course, everyone knows the Big Dipper, Wilt Chamberlain, right? You know, the only player in NBA history to score 100 points? Well, they both played together at one point in time. But period, that's not the point. The thing is that...
You got that in, though.
Well, hey.
Thanks, Matthew, for the education.
Hey, favorite number?
No, the re-education.
Well, you know, favorite number, old school. Old school, no, nothing like
some
the old school.
Just don't forget.
But Jerry West actually seemed to have symptoms of depression. You know, he growing up in his young life, his father would beat him for no reason at times, you know, with a belt. Mm-hmm. And it definitely caused him to feel hurt at times. Mm-hmm. Until one point in time, he actually stepped up to his father when you know, he kept the shotgun under his bed, and he said, hey, look, if this doesn't end, there's going to be some trouble. And you know, his father eventually died later of a heart attack. But he says he looks back to that day, and he wonders what exactly, how would he feel now? You know, this guy's in the NBA. He's Mr. Clutch. He's winning games, winning titles.
Isn't that amazing, you know? though, that even through all of that, he still want to know what his father would think about him now.
Well, the man forgives him, and you know, that's something. That's something that, you know, a lot of people probably have, you know, have had to go through.
Yeah.
And he's actually wrote a book about it. He calls it West by West, My Charmed, Tormented Life. Mm. And, you know, his wife and his, you know, his sons, his siblings, they asked him and said, "Hey, man, I don't know if you should really write something like that." And he said, "No, I want to go. I want to do this," because there are a lot of NBA players out there that, you know, or even NFL, that go through the things that, you know, push them, that give them something to really want to fight for.
Yes.
And you know, you look at guys like Kevin Durant, who wear the number 35 for his old coach. That's the age that he died at. You know, there's a lot going on. There's a lot going on out there sometimes, and it's just interesting to see the small pieces of motivation that can really push these players to want to win.
Yes.
And push these players to, if they had a bad life in the past, to go for a better life, not just for money and fame, mm-hmm. but for the fact that that's their outlet.
Yeah.
This is what brings them to happiness. This is what comforts them.
That's a great story, because, you know, people don't realize the life of these athletes. And, you know, there's a saying that people don't know the story behind the glory. So all you see now is this person that's, you know, living large and having all this stuff. And even Michael Vick's story, when you look at him, the very father that wasn't in his life, when all this went down, saying, "Well, I told him to stop," you know, he was the first one to run his mouth, you know, but he didn't have a great relationship with his father. So, you know, when you look at Wes and the fact that even during this time, his question was, "I wonder what he would think of me now." You know, that's just sad, but it's still good at the same time, because that great motivation is what causes them to be as great as they are. We know the Michael Jordan story, which he is my hunk, my guy. You know, I'm married, but you know, I still love me some Michael Jordan. MJ, what's up, baby boy? But you know what he went through. You know what I'm saying? He was playing ball and everything, and they told him he couldn't play, and they said no, and he was turned away. And he kept fighting, and now he is the greatest basketball player to ever walk this earth. I said it, and I mean it. He is the greatest basketball player to ever walk this earth.
Well, we want to get down to technical about that. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
He was good, but he wasn't Michael Jordan, okay?
He mastered.
Did he play with the flu?
Everything. He mastered.
Did he win a championship with the flu?
It was beautiful. But we all know that regardless of.
But I do love Kareem's hook, though, I have to say.
Whether it's Kareem, whether it's Wilt, whether it's Jordan, we have Mr. Clutch, the great Jerry West, as our one and only logo.
Yes. Yay. So, you happy about that?
And being the logo? Absolutely.
All I got to say is I'm just glad you found that story in the trash.
Well, like I said, you never know how old it is, but hey. We do got a lot. The show must go on, and we do got a lot to talk about. We got a lot coming up for Sundays.
Now, listen, real quick, I got to ask the question of Big Country, because we were talking about this before we came on air. The Philadelphia Eagles have chosen, what is his name, Chip West?
Chip Kelly.
Kelly out of Oregon. Chip Kelly out of Oregon. And they've chosen him to be over the Philadelphia Eagles, the coach, the head coach for the Philadelphia Eagles. Now, we had made some comments about, you know, how difficult it is for a college coach to come into the league and to coach the professionals.
Well,
Big Country?
Well, one of the things that you look at is that no experience. Experience as a coach is okay.
Yeah.
But you have rightly coaches, whether they are offensive line coach, defensive, backfield coach, receivers coach, who have kind of put their dues in the game.
Yeah.
And a lot of time the player have more respect.
Oh, that makes sense.
Nick Saban found that out when he was in Miami.
Uh-huh. So he already tried it.
Right, he tried it. And you have a few other coaches, like the guy came from Kentucky that would coach the Falcons.
Yeah.
He tried it for about 8 games or so and left.
He was gone after 8 games, huh? He was out of there.
Yeah. And so therefore, you know, they just don't pan out right. They need to put a little bit more experience in the game, because actually these guys are making millions and millions of dollars.
Uh-huh. That's true.
You can't put a $1,000 coach to coach these guys out.
Oh, there. Okay. So it is about a little bit about the money too.
Yes, it is.
All right. Well, people can say what they want to say. You heard it here on SIBN Sports. That's what Big Country said.
And y'all let us know what you think, folks. You know, don't sit back and just relax. Let us know what you think on our Facebook fan page, www.facebook.com/SIBNSports.fanpage. And also don't forget about our one and only website at www.sibnradio-byselectusatv.com.
Yes, check out our website. We've done some great improvements. Our producer has been working really hard on the website. We want to make it inviting for you and encourage you to come and check out our website and see what great things we are doing, because SIBN is not just doing sports. We're doing other things as well. Come and check out all our regularly scheduled programs. We're going to take a quick break. We're going to come back and break down these games. The Ravens and the Broncos, the 49ers and the Packers, the Seahawks and the Falcons and the Texans and the Patriots. Boy, we got some stuff to talk about. We'll see y'all in a few minutes. This is your girl, Clarice Leck, coming at you live.
Get to the game. Powered by American Family Insurance. Trey Matthews, one of the top safeties in his class, defined his playing style early on.
I started playing football when I was around 9.
They were doing head-on tackling drills. He was getting ready to hit a guy, and they was like, no, we're not going to let him go against him because he played last year. I was like, no, let him hit it.
Trey didn't know, well, what am I supposed to do? He's much bigger than I am. My husband said, just go at him and go full speed. And he just did it like he had been doing it since he was, you know, younger than 8 or 9.
He's never missed a practice, been late for one. He's a dedicated football player 12 months out of the year.
Trey's family is very close, and it's helped keep Trey on the path to his dreams.
The closest of our family is phenomenal.
When I step out of line, my mom is the first one on me.
I know I push him a whole lot more than what some of the other boys' parents do, but that, of course, will help him in the end.
Trey's dream is to be a professional football player. We work out together almost every night.
My dad taught me my work ethic. He taught me everything I know.
People talk about a plan B. We don't have a plan B. You put all that you have into your plan A. And if your plan A fails, then we'll work on another plan A.
The NFL is a big dream, and Trey has a plan and the support to protect it.
The best way to protect my dream is to stay focused, keep my body healthy, and hit the books hard.
When Trey starts to talking about what he wants to pursue, I just get behind him 100%. We have a motto that we live by, that's put God first, go hard, and have fun. That's in life, in the classroom, and everything that you do.
You do a lot of thinking on a bike, about your life, family, your dreams. One of my dreams came to me on a bike, to open up my own shop. So what happens when you complete a dream? Well, you just start thinking of the next.
You're listening to SIBN Radio on the Select USA TV iBroadcasting Network. You're listening to SIBN Radio.
Welcome back, folks. Right here at SIBN Sports, keeping you on top of your teams and news, stats, and wins. Matthew Bugs right here in the one and only
Clara Salette. Holla!
So check this out, folks. Speaking of Clara Salette,
what?
We have something, some very important news to state at the fact that Matthew was right.
What?
I was right. Remember, we I guess you just remember, folks. Last week, if this is the part where we rewind.
I thought we agreed on all the games except one, the 49ers and the Packers. Was the only game we didn't agree on.
Not the 49ers and the Packers. The Ravens
and the Broncos.
The Ravens and the Broncos.
Okay.
Now, this is the part where they rewind.
I'll take that.
This
no
is
problem.
The part where we rewind, and that's okay, sports. So hopefully somebody can listen to that from last week.
Oh, stop
He's
it.
Gonna, our producer's going to put in the rewind from last week, and they're going to say, yeah, she did say that. That'd be some awesome editing. But beyond that, the Ravens did beat the Broncos, folks. The Ravens did beat the Broncos. Now, they won 38-35, but the thing is, like I said, the defense did its part. The defense won that game.
And the defense won the game. Let's make that very clear.
Well, the contract.
It was for no nod that Broncos played and awesome. Is that MJ? I'm sorry. Did I just do that on live? Y'all know I'm an MJ fan. They showing old pictures of MJ going in for the kill. Holla! Okay, check this out. Now, let's talk about this game. Let's break it down, Matthew, while you tripping, okay? Let's not play around.
Right.
90 yards, punt return by Trendon Holiday to put the Broncos up 7-0. Then you had a 59-yard pass by Jeff Flacco. Go, Joe, to Torrey Smith. Four plays, 94 yards to tie the game 7-7. Now, this is where the turnaround took place for me. When Manning threw the interception, you had a 39-yard interception return by Corey Graham to put the game at 14-7. What that said to me was the defense was here to play, and if Peyton Manning slipped at all, they were not going to win this game. If he slipped at all, and that was just one slip, that was just his first one.
Well, check this out. There's also a lot of speculation, too. At the end of regulation, for those of you that don't know, the game went into overtime. At the end of regulation,
twice, double overtime.
Well, double overtime, yes. Yeah. At the end of regulation, they were told, the Broncos offense was told to kneel and take a knee. Shouldn't they? Don't you think they have drove downfield and probably gone for something to go ahead and end the game right there? But no. Coach says, we do not care. We will go with it regardless of
because
what
anybody else thinks. Because once you go into that second overtime, it goes to sudden death.
Well,
so why wouldn't you drive?
Well, it's like you said, Coach Fax, he said, I do not regret it. He would have done it 10 out of 10 times. And that's it.
People say they don't regret it and they lost a game. You lost an opportunity to go into the championship game and you don't regret it. You should regret that call. You should regret it because that was the game-winning call. What if the Falcons, and we're going to get to the Falcons in a minute. Y'all know I'm jumping ahead here. I'm getting excited. What if the Falcons had made that call at 37 seconds and gave up?
It is.
I'm just saying. See, the real coach says, we're going in, we're going to win at all costs. If it's only 37 seconds left, we're playing hard like it's, a whole bunch of time left.
That's exactly I got excited what Atlanta did. As we observe Baltimore doesn't have big-time stats, but we always know that the defense will always produce. You know, you got Ray Lewis down there that everybody knows and everybody loves. And they've got a lot riding on them right now. Mm-hmm. Baltimore is definitely heavy right now. They've got a lot of emotion.
But Flacco had a great game,
They've got
though.
A lot of emotion. They've got a lot of things going for them right now. And even beyond them, we told about the guys that stepped up right there on the D-line. Terrence Cody, Brian Hall, even their linebacker, Danelle Ellerby, Albert McClellan. All these guys have stepped up. They've stepped up big time. And now, with Ray Lewis being in the lineup, like we said, they've got a lot of emotion riding. They've got a lot of momentum.
Right.
They've got a lot going. As for the offense, it's like you did say, Joe Flacco is producing.
Anquan Boldin. He did 18 of 34 for 331 passing yards, no interceptions, and 3 touchdown passes.
And as well as Anquan Boldin, Torrey Smith, these guys are doing their job.
Playing well. Everybody
they're
did
doing
what
their
they were
job.
Supposed to do. I mean, when you look at the game and what happened, and then you have 15-yard pass by Peyton Manning to Brandon Stokley, to tie the game at 14-14. And then in the second quarter, this is where you had some shifts. 14-yard pass from Manny to Kaushan. How you say his name?
No Sean Marino.
Okay.
Marino. You know who he used to play for?
He passed him 8 plays. Who did he used to play for?
UGA.
Oh, I didn't know that. Awesome. And then the Broncos took a 21-14 lead. There was a 32-yard pass for Joe Flacco to Torrey Smith for a 21-21 tie. I mean, the game just stayed together until the end. Trendon Holiday had another return for a touchdown, which put Broncos up 28-21. So what I was trying to say is, even though I said the Broncos were going to win, based on this game, they should have won. But those two interceptions slips by Peyton Manning made the difference in this game because you had to be spot on to win against the Ravens. And any slip of the tongue, did I say slip of the tongue?
Yeah, the tongue.
I said that on purpose. Any slip is going to let you see what's going to happen. Now, we're going to get into this Falcon game because I know Big Country got some stuff to say. Yeah, listen, y'all.
Well,
I know you do, Big Country, because this game right here, let's talk about this game, y'all. So in the first quarter, the score was 10-0. In the second quarter, the score was 10-0. So that means that the Falcons scored 10, Seattle Seahawks scored 0. So in the first half, the Falcons were winning 20-0 over the Seahawks. Third quarter, Seahawks score 7, Falcons score 7. Falcons are 27-7 over the Seahawks in the third quarter. Are y'all following here? Are y'all following here? And here we go. Here we go in the fourth quarter, right? This is crazy. The Seattle Seahawks scored 21 unanswered points. Well, the Falcons did go and score 3, which was at the end of the game to win it. But 21 unanswered points to tie the Falcons. No, they took them up. They were up by 1, right? Yes, they were up by 1. So the Falcons had 37 seconds to win this game. And what do y'all think? I mean, I'm not going to say what I think right now.
Well, they really almost let the game slip. And so
they what now? Hold on. They did what now?
They almost let the game slip.
That's a little mild, don't you think?
Well, no, because they really did. I mean, here's the thing. Atlanta, like we said, what did we say last week?
They didn't let the game slip, Matthew. They stopped playing football.
This is the part where I wish we could rewind again. You know, if our producer can put in the edit to say, like, well, you know, goes back to last week that says Atlanta cannot be a team that has to play from behind. If they get a lead, they have to keep the lead. They have to control the game. Like they were doing from the get-go.
Right. But they had control of the game. So what happened to the control, Big Country? Big Country, what happened to the Falcons?
Well, one of the things that they did is that they went to sleep on the fourth quarter.
They went to sleep.
Yes, they did.
They went to sleep.
Nap time. They went to color.
They took a nap, huh?
Drink your milk, take your nap.
And, you know, I think what happened was they got a little comfortable in this game. And for some reason, they felt like they didn't have to really play hard anymore. Because let me tell you, one of the things that I analyzed the most in that game was the defense and how our defense played in the end. Where was our defensive coordinator? Because there was no pressure on the ball and on Wilson. He was running all over us. He was throwing passes. This dude was like, he had so much time. I was like, damn, fix me a hamburger. I mean, he had way too much time in the bag, man. I'm serious. That was a huge breakdown in the defense. And don't give me that Abraham wasn't in the game crap. We got enough guys on that line that could have made this happen. Decoo didn't get any interceptions. Sante Samuels, no interceptions. McClain, no. I mean, what was going on with our defense at the second half?
Remember Big what Country. We said.
Well, Claire, I like to say one thing.
Yeah.
Coming up for the next two games, they only got to play 2 hours work. 1 hour for Sunday. Just all 1 hour.
Uh-huh.
We need to get the players all hyped up and souped up for this game.
Yeah. What's it going to take?
It's going to take motivation.
Mm-hmm.
And that everybody got to show up.
Everybody got to show up?
They got to show up and come to play.
Come to play. And you think that's going to happen?
Yes.
Okay.
I think that's going to happen.
All right, Big Country said it. You heard it here on the SIBN Sports Desk. Big Country said the Falcons are going to come to play against the 49ers. Let's talk about the 49ers over the Packers. 49ers beat the Packers 45-31. That was a complete blowout. You know, we talked last week about Kaepernick. When we come back from our next break, we are going in on this Kaepernick thing because that boy is coming to the dome and he is coming to play. Does he look like a contender or what, y'all?
He ain't no joke, Claire.
He ain't no joke. We'll be back, y'all. This is SIBN Sports.
SIBN Radio. We'll be right back.
to SIBN Radio. We'll be right back in a moment. Now is the time to have your business online with the Select USA TV iBroadcasting Network. That's right, SIBN or Select USA TV will produce your video on the spot. Picture business videos, on location streaming videos, or on location production videos. Dial 678-830-3118 or call the office at 404-910-5019 Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Now is the time to have your business online with SIBN. The Select USA TV iBroadcasting Network now offers picture videos, on-location streaming videos, and on-location production videos for your event, cause, brand, or mission. Call today, 678-830-3118 or 404-910-5019.
Right, but a talking gecko, why?
I'll tell you why. Because people trust advertising icons. Some bloke tells you to go to geico.com and you're like, really? And just who might you be? But a gecko, he can be trusted. I ask if you want to save hundreds on car insurance, and you're like, yes, thank you. Mind babysitting my kids. And I'm like, of course I'll sit with the kids. You're like a brother to me.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
It's 2:30 in the morning, and your mom just woke me up because she had her very first craving, and so we came to Burger King so she could get a Whopper.
So good.
Burger King is celebrating 55 years, a Whopper sandwich, and inviting you to share your best Whopper moments.
Thanks for waking me up.
Thanks for buying me a Burger King.
I was once used for small jobs.
And I took on all the bigger, tougher ones. But with Mr. Clean's new Select-A-Size Magic Eraser, he can take on any size job.
At least we don't go near Rex's mobile home as often.
What are you, scared?
New Mr. Clean Select-A-Size Magic Eraser.
The call to serve. It has no sound. Yet I have heard it. In the whispered retelling of honorable sacrifices made by those who have served before me. The call to serve has no form. Yet I have clearly seen it in the eyes of men and women infinitely more courageous and more driven than most. The call to serve has no weight, yet I have held it in my hands. I will commit to carry it close to my heart until my country is safe and the anguish of those less fortunate has been soothed. The call to serve is at once invisible and always present. And for those who choose to answer the call, for their country, for their fellow man, for themselves, it is the most powerful force on earth. America's Navy, a global force for good.
You're listening to SIBN Radio on the Select USA TV iBroadcasting Network. You're listening to SIBN Radio.
Welcome back right here, folks. SIBN Sports. Folks, we want to make sure that you put in your input and your 2 cents on our fan page, www.facebook.com/SIBN Sports fan page, as well as www.SelectIBroadcastNetwork or SIBN Radio /SelectUSATV.com. Make sure that you check that out. Folks, I want to get into something right here. San Francisco. I don't quite think I pushed into their stats, but check this out. They're ranked 11th in the league in points, which is almost 25. 11th in the league in yards at 361, almost 362. Passing yards, they're ranked 23rd at 206. However, check this out. They are 4th in the league at rushing yards at almost 156. Now, here's the thing with that. Colin Kaepernick is definitely one of the culprits here in the jump of their rushing yards. This guy can flat out run that football. And really? He's actually one of the top rushers on the team next to Frank Gore. And that's actually pretty interesting.
But that's the funny part that we were talking about before we went to break is that I think Big Country was mentioning, we're going to let him talk a little bit about this, is that the rushing quarterbacks in the league right now, it is ridiculous. I mean, we know RG3 is one of them. We know Cam Newton is going to be one of them. You got all of these guys who are rushing quarterbacks. Let me talk about the stats on Kaepernick before I cut loose with Big Country. We're going to talk about his passing yard first, and I'm going to show you something here that's really amazing to me. He was 17 of 31 for 263 passing yards. He threw one interception and scored two touchdowns. Now check out his rushing numbers. 16 rushes for 181 rushing yards. Yes, 181 rushing yards, two touchdowns rushing. Just two touchdowns rushing this kid.
Hey, and check this out. You got to admire San Francisco with especially what he's done. Because check this out. They flipped the script after the first quarter. They only scored 7 points, which is not bad. I mean, you score. But they scored 17 points in the second, 7 in the third, and 14 in the fourth. After that point, they outscored. They outscored their opponents.
Right.
Green Bay, as we all know. They outscored them.
Mm-hmm.
And like we said, you got to admire what this guy's doing. Kaepernick is adjusting to a leadership role where he's taking the reins of this team and just driving almost like RG3 in a way.
Right, right.
Like I said, that's
And that's
admirable.
Huge because Big Country, don't you, what do you think about that? The fact that they took Steve Smith out. Do you think it had to anything to do with the versatility that it has caused given this advantage to San Francisco?
Yes, I really do, Claire. One of the things that I looked at was that they're running, and that brought more excitement to the game. And that's what the fans were pretty much looking at, you know.
So you would be excited about that. I mean, as a fan, that's something that you look for, excitement in the game.
Well, what they brought around was that if he runs and they play man to man in defense, somebody's going to be open.
Right. That makes sense.
So the dimension of the game, like we used to do out there in the cornfields, and we used to throw corn cobs around.
Yeah.
And have a good time with that. That's what they're doing out there. They're throwing corn cobs.
They're throwing corn cobs on the field.
On the field.
And so used to run through the husky, kind of hide and stuff like that, and use it as like it was a defender?
Yes.
Okay. So that's what Kaepernick is doing too.
Right. By him being
He learned in the cornfields how to do what he do?
No, he was out on the Urban League in a practice field.
He was?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Well, but I think somebody from the cornfields must have got in his ear, though. Don't you think, Big Country?
Well, one of the things that I looked for, Claire, was that as he started progressing and growing,
yeah,
in the limited time that he started quarterbacking and taking over the team, was that everybody gelled. The energy of the team
like
started
that.
Gelling.
Okay.
The offensive line, for once, they wanted to block for a multi-dimensional quarterback.
Yeah.
And what the quarterback did was that when he run, he might not cross the line of scrimmage, but he would allow the end to get open.
Nice.
And
if the other
team tried to get with him and tackle him, he just pass it on off to one of them running backs, and whoopee, they got a first down. I just love football.
I know you do. Big Country said it here, y'all, on SIBN. He said, whoopee. I don't know if I can say it. You know what that sounds like? What's that commercial with the guy called?
Wait a minute. Pig?
No, the pig. Oh God, what's the pig all day? He said, whee.
Oh,
whee.
With the pinwheel.
That's what that sounded like just now. Let me say this. Big Country, we love your analogy. That was amazing. The cornfields just brought me back to the cornfields of Oklahoma where I grew up.
Well, you know, Claire, I just love the pigs. They're part of my football team out there. We used to
So y'all had pigs running around.
We had pigs and cows and horses. We'll line them up now.
That's what I'm talking about, Big Country. So this is, I think that's good because, you know, when you look at Kaepernick and what he's done for San Francisco, you know, he's making them look like a bunch of pigs running around looking like they don't know which way to go.
Okay.
And now's a good time to remember that. Speaking of San Francisco and running around and causing all kinds of madness and stuff, They're a team that average more points on the road than they do at home.
Oh, that's so crazy.
Now's a good time to remember that. Causing disruption in everybody's farms and, you know, crop dusting the wrong kinds of the folk and all kinds of whatnot.
Yeah.
They can cause damage on the road. Yeah. So Atlanta's got to be careful this next game.
Right. And so, hey, that's a huge statistic. And that statistic says a lot about what they're going to bring to the Dome. I'm going to say this to all of you Falcons fans out there. I'm going to sound like Big Country. I need y'all to stand up on your feet, and I make y'all to make some doggone noise up in that dome. We need some Falcons down noise up in that dome. Y'all need to get loud up in here. You know what I'm saying? They a little quiet sometimes. Big Country, you think you can help with that?
Yeah, it's kind of like late at night when you got the chickens and you got the horses and you got the cows and you got the pigs and you got the ducks and you got the quack quack. Everybody just having a good time.
A whole bunch of noise.
That's how the Falcons Dome gotta be.
All right. You said it here, Big Country. You right about that one. Now, listen, y'all. Another game was the Patriots and the Texans. That is the only game that went the way everybody thought it was going to go.
I told you that one.
Both said that that was going to happen. We didn't see that the Texans was going to have a chance against the Patriots. But what does that say about the Patriots team that's coming to play the Ravens, though? We're going to have to talk about that in a little bit. But the Patriots beat the Texans 41-28. Wasn't even a game. It was pretty much, to me, a shutdown blowout. New England, 7-3. First quarter, they were 7. Houston was 3. Second quarter, Houston picked it up a little bit. It was 10-10. You thought there was going to be a game there. And then in the third quarter, New England was 14. Houston was 0 points. That let you know that there was no coming back here for Houston. Then New England was 10, and Houston was 15 to win the game 41-28. Now, we have been talking a lot about football. We've been talking about a whole bunch of stuff. But we got to get into the NBA.
And hold those horses, everybody, because everybody remembers, for my Atlanta fans, yes, they won against the Nets last night, but the Hawks set some very interesting franchise records. With a loss against the Bulls. Check this out, guys.
Yes. Talk about that. That's crazy.
Atlanta set records, but not in the direction that we wanted it to. They had the lowest points in franchise history. As, you know, the Atlanta Hawks team.
Right.
Now, luckily, Jeff Teague kind of, you know, dumbed that down some with a layup in the final seconds. But check this out, guys. In the second quarter, they only scored 5 points. 5 points in the second quarter is all they scored. They went 2 of 21. They 9.5% shooting. Mm-hmm. They did not do very good at all.
Right.
And so you got to wonder, where in the name of Moses did the breakdown happen?
Right.
And on top of that, the Hawks shot almost, 29% from the field.
Oh.
They were 23 of 81 overall in the game.
Oh. Yeah, that was a sucky game.
It was a very bad game for them. And, you know, they talked to Coach Drew, what happened, and they said these guys did it to themselves.
Right.
So, one thing he did promise was a lineup change.
I think they took Josh the team Smith for granted. You can't never take anybody for granted here. You got to keep playing your game,
Well, and, they were on the road. And Josh Smith, he tossed the ball. He tried to toss the ball back to the ref. Instead, it went into the bench. The team suspended him for last night's game against the Nets. And they actually played very well. They actually looked like an Atlanta Hawks team, and they did. They played very well.
You never know what's going on behind the scenes either. So something had to have happened to cause them to lose that game. So I think that's pretty interesting as well. Hey, listen, we're going to come back with some rundowns and things. We're going to talk about what's going on in the NBA and some of the teams to look at and those that are still playing very, very well and who are at the top of their conferences. So give us a second, y'all. We're coming back at the news desk. This is your girl, Clara Salette on SIBN Sports.
Aaron, I was able to save you hundreds.
Yeah, discount, double check, I know. I'm kind of over that move.
So are we.
What?
It's a little, soft.
No, it isn't.
It is.
They wanted something with a little,
Like what?
Do it with me. Ready? Discount, double check.
I like it.
Mm-hmm.
It's terrifying.
Right?
Matthews.
What's up, dude?
He plays football professionally.
Hey, Rogers! Move! Matthews!
You could save big with a discount double check, only from State Farm.
Hurry in for Customer Appreciation Month at Subway. We're saying thanks with $2 6-inch subs all December long. Either the cold cut combo or meatball marinara for $2 each.
Thanks, guys.
Gracias.
Danke.
Go for two.
Subway. Eat fresh.
You do a lot of thinking on a bike. About your life. Family. Your dreams. One of my dreams came to me on a bike. To open up my own shop. So what happens when you complete a dream? Well, you just start thinking of the next.
All right, y'all, this is our rapid fire rundown for the SIBN Sports. Again, this is your girl, Clara Salit, sitting at the desk today with Matthew Buggs and also our friend of the show, Mr. Big Country. We want to thank you for joining us today, Big Country. It has been a pleasure to have you at our desk. You have been an awesome commentator today.
I love it, too.
Thank you very much. So we're so glad how much you love sports.
Anytime I can help, just let me know.
Yes, sir. We're going to have you back. Thank you so much for joining us. Go ahead, Matthew.
And a big shout-out, guys, as we quick wrap up everything. Big shout-out to LeBron James, being the youngest player in NBA history to reach 20,000 career points, as well as 5,000 assists. Great job, the young fella.
And being so young, too, to do that, that's awesome. Hey, and before we go, I got to give a shout-out to our First Lady, Michelle Obama. Today is her 49th birthday. Happy birthday, Michelle.
Oh, no. Oh, my
She's
word.
49, and she looks so beautiful. And today is also Steve Harvey's birthday. Happy birthday to you also, Steve Harvey, with the Steve Harvey Morning Show. Love listening to Steve Harvey on the Morning Show. And also want to give a shout-out to my sister, Anita. Her birthday is also today. Happy birthday, little sister. Have a wonderful day. Yeah, I did a birthday. Shout out. Can you believe it? Listen, as we do the rundown here, what's going on? You got San Antonio still playing very well. They're at the top of the Western Conference Southwest with 28-1, 11 games. Oklahoma City still playing very well. The Thunder is looking very well, aren't they? They've only lost about
powerful
six
team.
Games or so. Huh?
Powerful team.
Powerful team. I mean, just ridiculous. KB is just, KD Durant, Kevin, is doing his doggone thing, you know? New York is still on top, doing very well. You got Miami. Just Miami is just ridiculous. The Hawks lost a very upsetting game to the Bulls, but you know it's the Hawks. You know, but they're coming back. They're still playing well. Now listen, the matchups for this week with the Falcons playing the 49ers at the Dome. You also have the Ravens playing the Patriots. Both of these games are going to be huge games. You got the NFC and you got the AFC. Who's going to the Super Bowl?
All right, check this out. If Atlanta can keep on top. If Baltimore can keep their defense rolling, I definitely believe that Baltimore can win this game if they can halt Tom Brady. They've got a lot of stats.
They're
ranked first in the league and a lot of stuff. But, hey, they've got to hold it down. They've got to keep Brady from having a free day.
So we are shouting out for the Ravens to win that game, and we are definitely going with the home team, the Falcons.
They got a lot of momentum. They lost the AFC Championship.
Over the 49ers. Let's get it done, y'all. This is your girl, Clara Salerno, and SIBN Sports. Join us again on next week as we bring to you all the hottest news in sports. Go ahead, Matthew. I'm sorry. I got excited.
I'm Matthew Buggs, keeping you on top of your teams and news, stats, and wins. This is SIBN Sports. Once again, I'm Matthew Buggs, and this is SIBN Sports.
Listening to SIBN Radio on the Salud USA TV iBroadcasting Network.